So my mom and I were talking about why older men have to go for younger women, and my most recent ex is a perfect example of why. First of all, he should have went younger, 'cause I'm 31. So I was 30 when we started dating. So like, I'm not the one or the two. But at this point in my life, I peep manipulation and slap a price tag on that bitch. I don't think I'll do it anymore. Like, I really think I'm done wasting my time with shit like that. But if you ever do have a man try to run game on you, or a woman, if they got money, run it. But anyway, let me give you some of the tactics that he used to try to use on me. So out the gate, love bombing, right? But I don't really see that as a red flag because I love a good love bomb. Like, of course you're in love with me right away. Why the fuck wouldn't you be? I'm amazing. And I give it back. So like, it's cool to me. I'm also a little bit toxic, but it's fine. But so we ended up getting back from vacation, and then he ended up going out on a double date with the couple that we were on vacation with and his ex, right? The couple that we were out on vacation with had posted a picture of it. I obviously followed the woman on Instagram. So like, I saw it, freaked the fuck out, obviously. At this point, I'm very much still in it, right? Like, I'm like, oh my God, we're in love, like, da da. And his immediate response is, oh my God, you're so insecure. I'm insecure because you went on a double date with your ex. Got it. From that moment on, it's up. Like, there's nothing for us to talk about. You're not about to like gaslight me into some weird ass situation that you got going on that you clearly can't let go of your ex's titty, which is cool, but you got money, so I'm gonna use it. The second type of thing he would do would be to do these long, drawn out arguments. Like, what I'm telling you, we would get on the phone and he would just talk for like, I'm not kidding, 7-8 minutes straight. I'm not new to this, I'm true to this. I know that you just let a man keep talking enough, he'll dig himself into a hole or let you know exactly what you're trying to figure out anyway. You know what I mean? So I wouldn't interrupt him. I'm just letting you, and I'm just watching the clock like, wow, this is a really, really long point. Especially for someone who's in the wrong. But that is a tactic. Like, people really try to like, you know, talk until you get confused or tired enough that you don't want to argue. And the third biggest manipulation tactic to me was just inconsistency. Sometimes $1,000 was absolutely nothing. Sometimes $1,000 was way too much. Anything for my personal enjoyment was like not worth the money. But if both of us were going to be enjoying it, oh, absolutely no problem. We can hop on a plane, go to Miami, blow 10K for the weekend, no problem. Or on trips that he didn't want me to go on, it was like, oh, I don't know, like, I don't really want to spend $3,000 on a flight, but then would literally go buy a new car the next day. But yeah, like, at 20 years old, all of that shit probably would have worked on me. You know what I mean? I don't know finances that well. So like, I'm not going to be like counting your pocketbook and clocking like how much you're paying for this versus how much you're paying for this, right? I'm not used to arguing at 20 years old. So you start giving me these drawn out monologues, I am going to get confused and bored and yawn and just let you win. So yeah, young babes, he doesn't think you're mature. He thinks you're dumb.